that's good. Yeah.
So like,
what is that?
As usual.
I want to be cool. I want to be one of those girls. You know? Hello guys, welcome back to another video. It's literally been long. I haven't posted a vlog in so long. I feel like it's so long because I think I've just been studying and stuff. Today's Friday and reading week has literally just started. I just came from school right now. I came from school, showered. I've just literally showered and yeah, I just did my a little bit of skincare. And yeah, now I'm just gonna get ready. I'm going for just movie night, but I just wanted you guys to see my get ready process properly because I feel like in other vlogs I don't really get ready properly. We're gonna start with the hair because I just literally just let my hair down. I never do anything with it, but we're gonna try another hairstyle today. I really don't know how to do my edges. I don't even have things to do my edges with. I only have like this edge brush, as you can see. I know this isn't for edges, but I do use it for my edges, and I have this as well. I used to have the edge booster, but it got finished and they don't even sell the big ones anymore. If you know where to find them, tell me, because I need the edge booster back. Yeah, but I'm gonna use the Echo Styler gel. Just gonna put it on top, and I unbraided one of my hairs, so yeah, she was hanging on for dear life. So I just decided to like unbraid her.
Oh my god, what is that?
Yeah, so like,
oh my god, what is that?
I'm going to go to the mall like I do in every vlog, but I don't really go there too. Like, it's just a nice walk. I prefer walking in the mall because I think it's safer than walking on the streets. Like, I just fear walking in the streets, to be honest. Yeah, but we're gonna go to the cinema and watch a movie. Maybe we're gonna eat something. I don't know, like, if anything, I'm gonna go with my camera. I'm gonna come with you. You guys are gonna come with me. If anything fun happens, I will show you guys. But we're just gonna go to the movies, and we usually go to Yorkdale Mall because it's like just more accessible, and we're just like transport is just like a problem in this country. Everywhere you need to drive, like at least to all the cinemas we want to go to, one is really far by TTC, by public transport, and the other one is like, they're all far actually. The only near one is the one at Yorkdale, which is like the mall that I always go to. So yeah, so as you can see, this looks ugly, but you know what, trust the process. We're just gonna comb them out so that they're like, they're free, you know. Yeah, I'm also trusting the process. I don't know what's gonna happen. Like, you guys are, we're experiencing this in real time together, because I don't even know what I'm doing. Why do you do this to yourself, Angel? Why do you embarrass yourself? I really have tried. Like, there's one time when I had just plaited this hair, I sat in front of my laptop with my mirror with this edge brush and my edge booster before like it was finished. Do you know, I stayed there for like, yeah, I stayed there for like 30 minutes to an hour, actually. It was an hour just trying to do my edges to perfect them, and I failed, literally. I don't know why. Everybody's falling in love, but I'm falling behind. I just, like, stop it. I'm gonna just cover them. So, every time I am gonna do my makeup, I don't want to do it because I like the way my skin looks. There's just like a plumpness in my skin. Like, it's not just because I have big cheeks, but like the skin itself is like really like good quality skin, and it's just like, it's a very big change on my skin that I can tell, and it's, I just love it so much. So we're basically just gonna take these two front sections of my hair, and then we're just gonna separate this from the rest of the hair, and then we're gonna put this hair in a bun. In a bun. That's weird.
It's a thief in the night to come and grab you.
Well, this is how it looked, but mine doesn't look that good, to be honest. But you know what? We're gonna try either way. If it fails, then this is how the hair stands. So in the video, it looks like the girl, she's like pulling her hair from like the front, and then she's like being creative. Is actually very like stressing, because this is so stressful. I want to be cool. I want to be one of those girls, you know. I want to be one of the cool kids.
I'm gonna get transit.
I just,
you know what, I think she tied something on top like this,
and I just have to make it tight.
I didn't have like a shortage of hair bands, to be honest, but we're gonna make this. Okay, I see what she did. Oh, I was wondering. Okay, so I think I've done it. But mine just kind of looks different from hers. I guess because the braids are different. But yeah, I think this is the hairstyle. I think this is it. Okay. Oh. You know, like, I kind of like this, actually. I'm gonna love it. And then, you know, my edges already, like, somehow I did themselves. But, wow, this is actually, I see the vision. Okay, I see you, girl. You're creative, girl, in this world. Okay. No, yeah, I got this. Actually, my neck, sorry, like, this is cute. You can't say to me that this isn't cute, because I want to listen to you, because I'm convinced it's the cutest and like convenient, most convenient hairstyle. Like, it just looks very, very like, honestly, like, I like it. I like this hairstyle. Well, I don't know, maybe I shouldn't tie this hair around. Maybe I should just find a way of putting it in the back. Maybe it would be better that way, instead. I think it would be better. Maybe like, when it's not like in the back here. So maybe I can tuck it in the back here, somehow. Maybe it's suspended in my head. Oh, maybe I could do a fluffy. No, that isn't good, because I guess the only way is to take it off there, but I don't like the way it looks like here. It just makes the whole thing, like, I guess I look bulky. I can just leave it like that. I don't see another way out of this. I'll just try and push it as far as I can. I guess maybe that's what she also did. I think it looks cute, though. I'm not gonna hold you. It looks cute. It looks cute. I believe it looks cute, and it will look cute. I'm just gonna fasten it. Just a little powder, and this already looks really good. Like, I don't know why my makeup looks so flawless today. Before I even add like the eyeliner,
That's current stuff. Even I don't even have anything on my lips, but they look so good. It's because I added the contour, by the way, on top. Yeah, but wow. Wow. I love the way my makeup looks today. I do. I really do. I really do. Eyebrows. If you can see, that's what I'm looking for. And has a little spoolie. Focus. Focus. It won't focus, but yeah, just know it's a spoolie. Are you seeing the sweat? Sweat wants to ruin my day. Like, sweat, you don't want to do this today right now. Like, you don't want to do this. You don't want to mess with me. Yeah, so you have to remain still and just follow. Like, just do straight. The shape of the eye when it's hooded. So therefore, it won't, like, be weirdly curved. I don't know why people like don't know how to do eyeliner. It's like the easiest thing ever. Okay, so makeup is all done. Let's go to the outfit. I don't know what I'm gonna wear for my outfit, but I know it has to match like the way I'm feeling. Like, okay, let me tell you guys what I'm considering, how I plan my outfits, or like, yeah. So first of all, I have to put into consideration how I feel, like body wise like am I confident about my body today or not, and then how I feel internally, what do I really want to wear, like, you know, when what do I feel like eating kind of vibes. And then also I want it to match my mood for today, because today I'm actually really in a good mood, so I want some color. Plus it's fall. By the way, this hair is for fall, if you didn't even know. Like, I chose this color. So yeah, we're gonna see how that turns out. Yeah, so I'm gonna show you guys my options. Okay guys, so these are my options. I'm thinking jeans. These jeans, I like how they look on me. So, and this top. And I'm going to show you the jacket in a few. This skirt, it's like long, but sorry, I have like, that's kind of trash, but anyways, this skirt is like, it's a long skirt that's like a bodycon skirt. And then I like this thing, and for these ones I wanted to wear like a bigger leather jacket. I'm going to show you guys with, again, a scarf. I'm going to show you guys this one. I also want a scarf with it. All of them, I want a pink scarf with them. So it's either this one, but this one has short sleeves because I just like this. I feel like this will give a nice aesthetic to my outfit. And then this is just like a basic white top with like a crew neck. Yeah, so it's either this and this with I don't think I like this and this with my leather jacket and scarf. It's just giving church. Then maybe I could do this with the jeans or this. Yeah, I don't think I want the skirt anymore. It's giving church. So I might do this with the jeans. This top actually has like a weird looking vibe to it. It was like in a set, but I didn't buy the pants with it. Yeah, it's kind of like wide, so it's not really like skin tight, but I can tuck it in actually, and it would give it. I got myself a chunky pink scarf for the winter and fall. So yeah, I'm gonna wear this because I just feel like color with this and the leather jacket. We'll try it on right now. And yeah, these shoes, as much as they're like
all over the place. Yeah, but I want to wear these two shoes to match this pinkness. Put it there. We'll see how it looks.
So this is like the other top. Let me just wear the whole outfit, how I planned it, and see how it looks. Okay. So this, I made this a crop top. And yeah.
So I changed out the jeans because you know how I was telling you the factors about when I'm picking an outfit is that I have to feel comfortable, like body wise, and those jeans, like I wasn't feeling nice in them, basically, like my body dysmorphia was just crazy. These jeans, I feel better wearing them, and so I added the scarf, and I was just trying to like see how it would look nice. I don't think I went with that style of the scarf. Yeah, you see, I'm just gonna put it in front, and then yeah, and then so that it covers my stomach because it's bloated, just like that. And we're gonna be walking the mall anyways, so yeah, it will be just like that. So I'm just talking about the shoes. Those are the shoes I'm gonna wear, but it wasn't focusing. Oh yeah, now they're like J's, but then I feel like they tried to copy the Dunks and then they just went into other kind of shoes. I actually got them for like maybe $40 on sale at Quality Spring.
Hi guys, it's a new day and we're gonna build another outfit with me. I know like the one for Friday, I didn't like it that much, but let's try again today. I'm gonna just show you guys what I have. It's this jeans again. I didn't make the cut for Friday. These jeans, I think you guys have seen this on my channel before. This, the black jeans, I want to wear this, but like, you know what, let's just get dressed with me. I already know what I'm gonna wear, but I just wanted to have like, let's wear what I feel like I want to wear, like what I think will look good, and then if it doesn't like turn out how I wanted it to turn out, then we'll, you know, go from there. So this is how the outfit is looking. I'll show you guys in the mirror. And I wear like that. Cute. Yeah, that's the outfit. Yeah, cute.
I only have one bag that goes with this. I've been using this bag so much, but I feel like it's just a basic.
These are gonna be the shoes. My friend and I are gonna go for, it was supposed to be brunch, but I guess lunch, but at a brunch place. Yeah, and it's in downtown. So yeah, come with me to downtown. I have been to this place before, but she hasn't. I actually vlogged this place. Yeah, the morning after. So yeah, so come with me and my friend to the morning after.
This day was such a beautiful day. Look at how beautiful the sky looks. Look at how beautiful the sky looks there. But look at that guy. He was on some plot. So I was just taking selfies to see what he was doing at the back. But back to that beautiful sky. So we ended up going to Cafe Landwer because my friend was extremely, like, she wasn't feeling well. So yeah, we ended up going somewhere close. Cafe Landwer at Young and Shepherd. And yeah, I had never been there. It's much more prettier than the Cafe Landwer I've been to, the one at Yorkdale. But yeah, that is me. We got shakshukas and I got her green juice. I think she got a chai tea because she just wasn't, she was under the weather. But yeah, it was so cute and we had a nice time. So I didn't have time to introduce the next activity that we are going for, but as you can see, I'm dressed and it was in downtown Yorkville area, and it's a 3D art show or like orchestra, I would say. And it was immersive, it was amazing. 10 out of 10 recommend. We reached about 30 minutes late, but the actual show actually starts 30 minutes after. As you can see, the crowd is an older crowd because the thing is like very fancy. It was just a very fancy time. But guess what I did in this fancy place? I could not find a way to wear my 3D glasses. I actually had to, I later undid my hair and just wore it down. But yeah, it was just so frustrating doing that. But I, as you can see, I finally got the hang of it and I was able to wear my 3D glasses. The name of the show is so on point because it made a lasting impression on me.
Lasting impressions take you into the minds and works of the most famous names in art. During lasting impressions, we use the newest technologies as we transform these paintings into a new type of reality. This is immersive 3D LED holographic technology. You are carried into the paintings to see them just as these are.
Sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity. Vincent, this world was never meant for one as beautiful as you.
Hello guys, today is officially the last day of my reading week. I am not happy at all. Like, though this has been the best reading week that I've ever had, and I've only had like, this is like my fourth reading week, and yeah, this has been the best. Can you imagine? Yesterday we went for a 3D art show, or like they called it art orchestra. So yeah, it's basically like in this dark room that's like candle lit and really nice. The audience there, I think me and my boyfriend were like the youngest people who were there, but yeah, it was really really nice. It was very romantic and I really love art. We both love art, and we went for this Van Gogh immersive experience or something like that, and we loved it so much, so we had to go for this one because it's like the first 3D art thing in Toronto, and it was so amazing. Like, I wish I knew all the other artists, but I only knew Van Gogh and I think Claude Monet. I don't really know Claude Monet, and also like, I don't know the artist's name, but there's a song that played that I really like. Like, it was in French, all the songs were in French. I think the artists are French, but I don't know where Van Gogh is from. I don't remember his story properly, but he's basically a very great artist whose like art always looked like it was moving. I'm gonna show you some of the pictures. Like, can you see like the skies, the waters? Like, the art looked like it was moving, and I think he's the one who gave other artists the vision, or like the idea of making moving art. So the immersive experience, only his. So yeah, because his art always looks like it's moving, and yeah, I think he's the one who inspired the 3D art thing. I would like, I don't know, maybe I'm being wrong, but because his art always looked 3D, like when you look at the picture, it looks live, you know, it looks like there's life in it. It's literally so nice, so nice, so nice. Like you really feel like you're in the art. You feel like you're at sea. You feel like you're in the farm, some farmland or whatever, in the what, in the medieval times. And it was so nice. Yeah, and then after that we went to Constantine restaurant. No, it's just called Constantine Toronto. And yeah, we didn't expect to go there, but it was close to the place. It's in Yorkville. Yeah, so we went there. It was nice. Walked around in Yorkville because it's like a walkable place, and you know, it's nice. And yeah, I made this video over here. I love my outfit actually. I feel like you know what, go body positivity. Like I loved how I looked yesterday. The food at that place was, I loved my dessert. I didn't like the dark forest cake that my boyfriend got, but I loved my dessert, which was the baklava, apple spice baklava or something. Yeah, I picked it because it's like fall themed also. Yeah, but it was hard to eat, but I think it was really good. I liked the layers, everything in it. The main course, it was made, I won't even lie. But the place is very ambient, very nice. It's nice for like a group of friends. I could see like all the tables have like, the list number is 3 chairs. Yeah, so it's like a group, like maybe birthday party, dinners type stuff. So now that I've caught you up, today I'm going for another, like last year at around this time, I went for the first game, basketball NBA game of the season. So today I'm going for the first NBA game of the season this year. I never used to like sports actually, but I don't know, I just started liking sports recently, and I love that for myself. Well, in particularly basketball, like now I follow the game, I like the game. Like I never used to pay attention to that stuff, but now I do. I guess it's growing up, I don't know. Yeah, and we've been going for games. We were going for games in the summer for like the Scarborough Shooting Stars. Yeah, the Scarborough Shooting Stars were playing, and that's like the Toronto, I mean the Scarborough team. That's just like country level basketball, but now this is gonna be like, I guess, American Canada football. The Raptors is the only Canadian team, so NBA, that's what I can say. So yeah, today we're gonna watch the Raptors, and I don't even know the other team actually, I've not checked, but I'm just excited because it's the first game of the season, and it's actually preseason, but still the first game in Toronto. So yeah, it's still hype. I also posted stuff on Instagram, you guys should go check them out. Yeah, I'm feeling so good, like I don't know, I'm just feeling so good, so refreshed. I've even used my reading week. I've been studying, I've been cleaning, deep cleaning my room, reorganizing. I just feel good right now, like I just feel refreshed. Like I know that going back to school tomorrow, I'm just gonna be like calm, ready to study, gonna work hard. I've watched all my modules, lecture modules for one of the subjects. Like maybe I'm five classes ahead, so it's gonna be amazing. Let me show you my outfit. Today I didn't do build an outfit with me because every time I do build an outfit, I don't like the outfit. I feel like I do better thinking about it away from the camera, so I don't think we'll do that again. But yeah, this is the outfit. Cute, and the earrings, cute. I still have to do my makeup and my edges, but yeah, this, I just had to dress up quickly because I'm actually out of time. Guys, this is the makeup. I really like my makeup these days. It's like I have like a signature makeup look now. I always look the same with makeup. I like that for myself. And every time I do makeup, I just become a whole different person. Like my personality changes. This is the full look. I'm gonna wear my thingy. just like, if it's not that cold outside, I'm just gonna hold it in my hands just like this. These guys, I have to go so that we don't be late. Hi guys, so we are at the Union Station where the Scotiabank Arena is. But we're getting some coffee in this really cute place called...
What's this place called?
I've forgotten what it's called actually, but let me just show you guys. I've heard good things about this place. I think it's called Arabica, and Arabica coffee is the coffee from Uganda as well. So yeah, we're gonna have it and see how it tastes, if it passes the vibe check. But I'm pretty sure it's really good. It smells so, so good, and the place looks so, so clean and modern edge vibes. I like it.
The Raptors were playing an Australian team, so this was just kind of like practice for them. So it was good vibes in the audience. Everyone was just so happy to be there for the new season. It was so packed, more packed than last year. And those are the nosebleeder seats where we sat last year. This year we're sitting on like another level, so meaning next time we're going to be closer and closer to courtside. And that is amazing. I enjoyed the game so much that I wasn't even able to like record the actual game. I only recorded like the entertainment part, and that says a lot. Like, I'm actually a supporter. I love that for me.
Hi guys, so the game just ended. The Raptors won. The team that they were playing was an Australian team, so I think it's just like a practice. Much. Someone is hooting so badly. Like, stop being impatient. Like, the cars are gonna move. And why is he shouting at other people? God, Toronto is weird. But yeah, they were playing another Australian team, and yeah, they really did well. They got like 138 points, and the other team got like 93. So yeah, that was nice. This year, I'm just realizing that we did this last year, and I'm just realizing all the differences. Like, I have a camera now. You know, I'm just like a Toronto girlie now. I love that for me. And it was my second game in my life. Yeah, but this season I want to go for like more games.
We ended the night by going to rec room and just walking around. We played a few games, but I was really not interested in the games. I was just like interested in just the vibes and all. But we ended up playing a few games. We played the VR game and we played the basketball game. Yeah, that's all we usually play, just the basketball game. And yeah, this is the end of the video. Thank you for watching. And yeah, come back for more videos.
Let's go. That's fun. Wow!